For the filling, you will need half red bell pepper, thinly sliced, 1 carrot grated or julienned, 1/2 cup bean sprouts, 1/4 cup cabbage shredded, 1/2 an onion finely sliced, 1/2 teaspoon fresh ginger, 1/2 teaspoon garlic grated, 1/4 cup thin noodles pre-cooked, you can use rice or Chinese noodles, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, salt to taste, 1/2 a tablespoon of oyster sauce, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1/2 a teaspoon of pepper, corn flour, 1 tablespoon, some water to make a paste, and 1/2 a liter vegetable oil, and store-bought spring roll sheets. So I'm going to heat some oil in a wok. I'm going to let it heat up a little bit. To this I'm going to add the onions, ginger, and the garlic. And then to this we will add our red bell peppers, carrots, bean sprouts, and the cabbage. Nicely stir these. We want to cook till they are slightly tender. We need them a little crunchy. Cover and cook for about 2 minutes till their vegetables are slightly softened and the flavors have a chance to intermingle. You can see that they have become slightly tender. Just dry up the little liquid that may have been released by the cabbage. And now I'm going to finish this off by adding some sugar, salt, pepper, the soya sauce, the oyster sauce. Give it a good stir. And now to this I'm going to add the noodles. Now this is done and I'm going to just let it cool for a while. So the vegetables have now cooled off. I've heated some oil in a pan and I'm going to make a paste with corn flour and water. I'm going to keep it aside. And now I'm going to take a spring roll wrapper and I'm going to place it in front of me so that it looks like a diamond. The rest of them I'm covering with a damp cloth. Now to this we are going to add a little bit of our vegetable mixture. I'm going to place it like this. Then you keep folding it. And when you reach here, you take it in like this. Then with a brush, put some corn flour paste on the side like this and cover it up like this to make it into a cylinder. And also, it seals up the corner. So now once all of them are folded, I'm going to deep fry them in the hot oil. I'm going to deep fry them till they are golden brown and crisp on all sides. Crispy spring rolls served with sweet and sour sauce.
Ingredients for tomato pulao. 2 large tomato cut into cubes. Cooked rice 1 cup. Here I've used my regular rice. If you want, you can use any long grain rice or basmati rice also. 1 medium onion roughly chopped. Oil 2 tablespoons. Cumin seeds 1 teaspoon, 1 medium green capsicum cut into small cubes, ginger garlic paste 1 tablespoon, red chili paste 1 tablespoon, tomato sauce 3 to 4 tablespoons, pav bhaji masala 1 tablespoon, 1 carrot boiled and cut into cubes, green peas 1/2 a cup, salt to taste, lemon juice 1 tablespoon, few sprigs of fresh coriander, water 1 cup or as desired. Heat a non-stick wok, pour some oil in the wok. Now it's a time to add cumin seeds. Sauté till they start crackling. Add the onions and again sauté it for few more minutes until they turn light golden brown in color. Now add ginger garlic paste and again sauté it for a minute. When the onions and the garlic paste are nicely combined with each other, now you have to add red chili paste, tomato sauce, pav bhaji masala and mix well. Keep stirring it so that it doesn't stick to the bottom. Now add carrot, green peas, chopped tomatoes, capsicum and mix well. If you want, you can use any other vegetables here of your choice. You can also use potatoes, beans and cauliflower. And if you want to make it more richer for your guest, you can also add paneer cubes to it. Mix gently and add salt and finally 1 cup of water and keep mixing it. And then cover it with a lid for around 3 to 4 minutes. Now add lemon juice to it and mix well and then cover it with a lid. Now it's the time to finally add the cooked rice and mix gently and let it get heated through. And cover it with the lid for around 4 to 5 minutes so that all the spices and the rice are nicely mixed and cooked together. Now remove the lid and check. All the moisture has been taken by the rice and it is nicely cooked through and it has got nice tangy flavor. Now I'm going to plate it with tomato rice on the base and then some white rice in the middle and finally some green peas and fresh coriander on top. 1 cup of poha, 2 tablespoons of oil, 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1 teaspoon cumin seeds, 5 to 6 curry leaves, 2 green chilies chopped, 1 medium onion chopped finely, 1 medium potato into small cubes boiled, handful of unsalted peanuts, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, juice of half a lemon, salt to taste, 1 teaspoon of sugar, some fresh coriander to garnish. First put the poha in a sieve and wash it thoroughly under running water for around 2 minutes and keep it aside to drain. Meanwhile, heat oil in a pan on a very low flame and add the mustard seeds. When they start crackling, add cumin seeds to it, followed by curry leaves and then green chilies. Fry them until all the spluttering stops and then add the onions. Keep stirring on low flame until all the onions are fried nicely and become soft and translucent. Now add the peanuts and the boiled potatoes and keep stirring frequently for around 2 to 3 minutes. Now drain the excess water from the poha and add it to the pan. Stir it for a minute and add salt, turmeric powder and again stir well to blend all the ingredients. Cook for another 1 minute and now add sugar to it. Now cover it with a lid for around 2 minutes. And now open the lid and check. Now it's perfectly done. Now turn off the flame and pour some lime juice over the poha. Now finally garnish the poha with some fresh coriander and serve hot. 8 to 10 slices of bread, white or brown in pieces. 1 tablespoon of oil, 1/4 teaspoon of black mustard seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of split Bengal gram, that is chana dal, 1/4 teaspoon of split black gram, that is urad dal. Salt to taste, 6 to 8 curry leaves, 1/2 a cup of onion chopped, 1/2 a teaspoon of minced ginger, 2 green chilies chopped, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 big tomato chopped, 1 teaspoon of lime juice, some fresh coriander to garnish. Now in a wok, heat oil or ghee, then add the mustard seeds. When you hear the crackling sound of the mustard seeds, it means they are getting fried. Now add the cumin seeds along with the chana dal and the urad dal and fry them until they start to brown a little. Next, I am going to add the onions and fry till they become little transparent. Once that is done, now add the green chilies, ginger and curry leaves and fry them for a minute. Next, I am going to throw in my onions and stir it until little tender and mushy for around 2 minutes. Soon after that, add very little water to form a thick gravy-like consistency this way. Don't add too much of water, you can sprinkle very little water with your hands also. Now stir in the pieces of the bread and toss nicely and sprinkle salt, turmeric powder and red chili powder and mix well so that all the bread pieces are nicely coated with the masala. Do not overcook it as we don't want the bread pieces to be very soggy or stick at the bottom of the pan. If the mixture looks too much dry, then sprinkle some more water on the top and reduce the flame. Now add the lemon juice and coriander and mix well. Now it is done. Now serve hot and garnish it with some more coriander on top with wedges of lime. Bundi, 1/2 a cup, yogurt 1.5 cups, 1/2 a cup of water, salt to taste, 1 teaspoon of sugar, red chili powder 1/2 a teaspoon, roasted cumin powder 1/2 a teaspoon, chaat masala 1/4 teaspoon, black pepper powder 1/4 teaspoon, mint leaves chopped 1 teaspoon, fresh coriander 2 tablespoons, pomegranate seeds 2 tablespoons. First up, whisk the yogurt in a bowl with the water and keep mixing it. Don't add too much of water. You can adjust the water over here, how much ever thick or thin you want. Now add the salt, sugar, and all the dry spices like the red chili powder, now the roasted cumin powder, some chaat masala, black pepper, mint leaves and the coriander leaves, and stir well and mix everything and keep it aside. Next, soak the bundis in some warm water and let it stand for 10 to 15 minutes. After that, drain the excess water and lightly press the bundis with the help of your hand and squeeze the excess water from it. Don't do hardly and mash it. Once the excess water is removed, put it directly in the yogurt mixture. Keep doing this until all the bundis are used up. Now stir well and you can put it in any bowl or container in which you want to plate up. And then I'm going to garnish it with some red chili powder this way. And then the cumin powder. And some fresh coriander on top. You can serve this cold as well as at room temperature, and you can adjust the spices as per your taste. Here I'm also going to top it up with some pomegranate seeds on the sides, but this is perfectly optional, but I personally like the crunch and the sweetness of it in every bite, and it's my family's favorite.
1 cup of wheat flour, salt to taste, 1/2 teaspoon of carom seeds, 1/2 cup of water, oil, 3 to 4 potatoes boiled and mashed, 1 medium onion very finely chopped, 2 green chilies very finely chopped, some fresh coriander, 1 teaspoon of ginger chopped, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder and 1 teaspoon of dry mango powder. Take the wheat flour, put salt, carom seeds, oil and mix well. Now add water and knead the dough. Once you knead the dough, drizzle some oil over it and make a smooth dough. It should free from all the cracks. Cover the dough with damp cloth for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Take all the boiled mashed potatoes, mash it well, add finely chopped onions, salt, red chili powder, coriander powder, cumin powder, dry mango powder, chopped green chilies, chopped ginger. Now add fresh coriander. You can also add mint leaves if you want. Just make sure all the ingredients are mixed well. You can use any clean flat surface of your kitchen. Take a small roundel . Make a small bowl of it. Now take some of the filling and stuff into it. Now close it into a round pocket very slowly. If you want, you can remove the excess dough. It should not have any kind of cracks. Now roll it on a dry flour and then roll it with a rolling pin. You can also use some more dry flour if you want. Just make sure that it doesn't break. Now make the rest of the parathas in the similar way. Drizzle some oil in a non-stick pan and place the parathas over it. It takes almost 3 to 4 minutes on either sides. Now flip it over. It gets a very lovely brown color if roasted well. You can drizzle some more oil on the top if you want. Some people also make it with ghee.
Now make the rest of the parathas in the same way. My lovely stuffed aloo ka parathas are ready.